This is a Tidbit, a customizable numpad kit sold by Nullbits that supports multiple layouts with different keys, rotary encoders, and OLED displays. A link to the public tutorial on GitHub is available in the description below. This specific build, inspired by a customer review on the numpad, has one rotary encoder and one OLED display. We will begin with soldering the necessary electronic components onto the top PCB plate. This is an SMD, or Surface Mounted Device, LED, where the four metal contacts will be soldered onto the PCB and create an underglow effect in the numpad. In order for the LEDs to work properly, they have to be oriented so that the notch in the LED is aligned with the diagonal line in the PCB. Next, we can solder the reset switch. This will be used when customized keyboard functions are coded and flashed onto the numpad to override the existing firmware, which will be detailed in flash and testing. The 1N4148 diodes are then bent and fitted onto the PCB, with the black bars oriented on the top. These diodes allow current to flow in one direction only and are used for quick switching purposes, with one diode for each key on the numpad. After the diodes are soldered, we can solder the TRRS expansion jack. This TRRS jack would normally be used to connect the numpad to another keyboard in order to supply power and data to the other keyboard, which is commonly used in split keyboards. In this particular build, the TRRS jack will be installed but won't be used. Next, we will install the microcontroller unit, or MCU, onto the PCB. In order to do so, we first need to solder the male header pins. This is the BitC microcontroller, which will be used to interface the keyboard with a computer. After the BitC is soldered, we can solder the rotary encoder. We can then install the 0.91-inch OLED display module. This is done using four wires as opposed to header pins because the layout of the PCB lines are formatted in a different order than the OLED module, since the OLED module is designed to be positioned vertically over the BitC instead of horizontally over the diodes. The wires will connect to GND, VCC, SCL, and SDA, where the positions of GND and VCC are swapped, along with SCL and SDA when connecting to the PCB. After all the electronic components are soldered onto the PCB, we can begin flashing and testing the numpad. Custom keyboard functions are coded in C, then converted to hex files through MSys2, and finally flashed onto the board using QMK Toolbox. A tutorial on installing MSys2 and setting up QMK Toolbox is linked in the description below, provided by QMK. To flash the Tidbit numpad, the reset button must be held while the USB-C cable is connected to the board. Now that it is in reset mode, we can open up QMK Toolbox, navigate to the hex file created through MSys2, and flash it onto the board. With the firmware flashed, we can use tweezers to test each key on the numpad by completing each switch circuit. Now that we have confirmed that the PCB is working properly, we can add standoffs to the bottom of the PCB. Install the FR4 plate. And put in the pre-lubed Glorious Panda tactile switches. With the switches soldered, we can stack the acrylic spacer and the backplate. Then, the front acrylic cover can be installed to protect the diodes and OLED display. After that, the encoder knob is screwed on. And now the keycaps are pressed onto the switches. As an additional step, we can replace the backplate with a CAD and 3D printed case. Six millimeter and 16 millimeter M2 screws were used to replace the 3 millimeter and 10 millimeter M2 screws, respectively, to account for the thickness of the case. Finally, some rubber bump bombs are added to prevent slipping. And here it is, the finished product, the Tidbit Numpad. Thank you.